Welcome back to Royalty Soaps. My name is Katie Carson. I am the Duchess of Suds here on this channel. And if you are interested in purchasing any of my Tutti Frutti soap collection, including Grape Idea, Citrus Blossom, Watermelon Candy, Blueberry Cream, Blackberry Pineapple Mint, or today's soap, the Tutti Frutti soap, well, you can shop it today at royaltysoaps.com, 3 p.m. Central Standard Time. I will leave you guys a link down below. I'm letting you know well in advance that May's collection often goes really fast. All of the summer soaps do typically pretty well. So if you want to get it, I highly suggest you set an alarm. I will give you guys a reminder on Instagram to do so. Scamper on over there, get your soap. And without further ado, let's make some Tutti Frutti soap. Also follow me on TikTok and Instagram. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye. Okay guys, let us make the signature soap for this month, Tutti Frutti. I'm so excited because it has so many good colors in it. And I hope it all goes according to plan. So the first thing I have to do is pour my lye water solution into my oils. And by the way, I am starting filming tonight at 11:30 p.m. Time just got away from me. I had a lot I had to do. I had a lot I had to prep in here. And my siblings are sleeping. So I'm trying to be relatively quiet, but we're still gonna have a great time. Okay, so let's go ahead and blend this up. Okay, so now it's time to pour off my accent colors. I have three of them today, and this is a layered soap, so we're gonna have some teeny tiny little baby layers at the bottom. Okay, I'm going to pour off 15 ounces, which is a teeny tiny little layer. 15 ounces. Wow, that was way too much. Okay, so for the accent colors here, we're going to add the following. First is a mix of Flashdance, Mica, and Grape Ape. Next is a mix of Green Neon from TKB Trading and some Let Us Entertain You from Mad Mica's. And finally, we have a mix of Tennis Ball Breaker and, I'm pausing so that you will finish the sentence. You know what I've mixed Tennis Ball Breaker with, don't you? Look at it. What is it? Say it aloud. That's right. True Yellow from TKB. And then eventually into the main mix, we're going to add some titanium dioxide and some poppy seeds. I hope that gives it a very dragon fruit appearance, but I don't want to mix anything into these layers because I don't want it to set up too fast. So I'm gonna go ahead, wipe this down just a little bit so that I don't add too much extra batter. So we're gonna mix up green first. I'm gonna set these guys off to the side. And then to this container, I'm going to add the proper amount of fragrance oil. Just about yay much. And then I'm going to blend it with my stick blender. Okay, so now I'm gonna pour this first layer into my two brambleberry molds. Like I said, a very thin layer. I'm gonna have to shake that around and then texture it a little bit. And they're gonna be slightly uneven because unless you judge like 100% perfectly when you pour that in, then every batch is gonna have a little more perhaps of the green or the yellow or whatever, just because, you know, it's handmade and we're perfectly imperfect. Yes, and this is setting up quite well. I did blend it for quite a long time because I really wanted it to. Actually, maybe I won't texture it. It's definitely firm enough for me to pour on top of it. Ooh, experiment time. Let's not texture and see how we like it. All right, so let's pour in our yellow now. Ugh, what a lovely color. And of course, to brighten up a yellow, you always add a neon. True Yellow is really, really bright as it is. Like, it doesn't need that much help. But because I was going for a tropical look for the soap, I went ahead and added just a smidgen. Time for the raspberry, the kind of purple acai color, I suppose. Blue. All right, final layer. Okay, oh goodness, oh Katie, oh be careful, Katie. Be careful, precious, be careful. I can't talk. All I can do is ladle.
Well, this fragrance oil blend is performing quite splendidly. Quite splendidly indeed, I must say. Okay, so now I'm gonna go let this set up for a little bit and I'm gonna mix up the soap frosting. We'll start piping the tops and I cannot wait to show you guys the embeds after this quick commercial break. Ba 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 ba. An acai colored soap frosting. You're welcome. It is now like 12:15 at night, and I waited for I want to say 25 minutes for the soap frosting to set up, which felt like a really long amount of time, and I think it's just because of how late it is. Plus, I'm a very busy, very busy, very busy man. Only people past probably the age of 45 are gonna know that reference. I only know it because my parents used to buy me cassette tapes that were quite old that they watched when they were kids. Does anyone know the Very Busy Man song? Or how about, oh yes, I remember. A tall man with a very bad haircut would say something like, "I think it's going to rain outside." And a small moose puppet would then say, like, "You know what, I wish it would rain, Captain." And the captain would say, "What's that?" And he said, "I wish it would rain ping pong balls." And then the captain would say, "Oh," and ping pong balls would literally fall out of the sky onto this very tall man with a bad haircut's head, while a small moose puppet jumps up and down and goes, "Yah, yah, 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 yah." Captain Kangaroo was a very educational person, and I believe the show aired in 1970, and he had a little moose and a little bunny, moose and bunny, that were kind of his assistants and would help teach the kids about animals and about songs and about places you can go. Our personal favorite was the Going Places episode. One of the places that Captain Kangaroo takes you is an ice cream factory, which of course as a kid is like the coolest place you could possibly go. And Kenny and I really, really, really loved that episode. Okay, so now I'm gonna put the very last dollop on top. And now for some hollow. I'm going to put the glitter on before the embeds because, well, the embeds are kind of a lot. Load this brush up real good. Shaky, shaky. And now it's time to place our little acai soap gumballs on top. So these are made with white melting pour and just a few poppy seeds sprinkled into the mold. That way they float around a little bit. If you don't get a suspension melting pour base, then adding in little embeds like that may or may not work because they will sink. They're heavy in the base. But a suspension melting pour soap base will indeed suspend them and keep everything floating around. You can get those from Wholesale Supplies Plus, I know at least, and then Brambleberry may or may not have them. Gracious, I have so many dishes to clean when I'm done with this. See, when I come over here, Caleb doesn't come over here in the morning to clean up my stuff. See, when I come over here, I have to clean my own dishes. So I have a whole bunch of dishes to do. So I've got to load a whole bunch of dishes and clean up all of my containers and everything after I finish filming. So I feel like I'm probably gonna be rolling into bed around 2 a.m. tonight. The next additive is one of these little green embeds. Also, it's not really an additive, it's an embed. And I'm gonna place it in such a way that we're getting to see the most of the embed, like so. And you're also getting to see the little curly top. Ugh. So cute, so tropical, totally reminds me of like a fruity drink. Hello mother, hello father, here I am at him, Granada. Apparently being sleepy will make me sing songs. And finally, I have some little mango chunks. These are made out of melt and pour soap.
So it looks like I can fit about two of these per soap. I said two or three, and there might be a couple of them that I can fit three on. Looks like this is about to be one of them, but for the most part, all of these soaps are gonna have two little soap mango chunks, and these are a slightly different color than the yellow on the inside, but I wanted it to look like a real mango, so that's the way it has to be. Well, I truly hope that you guys have enjoyed the Tutti Frutti collection. It really was a super fun one to design. I felt like I was in my element. I felt like this was a very, very good collection to kind of represent royalty soaps. Like, if you had to just pick one collection from this year so far, I'd say this is the most on brand for us. It's a lot of fun, a lot of bright colors. Lots of fruity scents. It's kind of just what we are.
The last melon.
Well, the last mango, really. Okay, so we are done. Looks a little something like this. Mmm, very symmetrical. I love it.
Wow. Caustic frosting. Forbidden frosting. I cannot wait to chop into this. That's exactly what I'm going to do in 18 to 24 hours. We'll take a little peek at the inside after this quick commercial break.
Oh my gosh, you guys, it's the last soap in the Tutti Frutti collection, completed, ready to cut. I'm so excited. It looks so good. Look at the lines. Ooh. I cannot get enough. This was such a fun month, and I feel like we all needed it so badly. Like, I don't know what it is. At the beginning of 2021, most everyone I know has just kind of had a rough first part of the year. And it seems like 2021 has been even harder than 2020 in some ways, so we just needed some bright, cheery colors to look at, and this is what it looks like on the inside. So you got those lines, you've got the dragon fruit in the middle here, you got dragon fruit on top. It's so balanced, this bar. I just love it to death. Now, looking at this, of course, has reminded me of dragon fruit, which I've only had a handful of times. Have you ever had dragon fruit before? That's the question of the day. And not like dragon fruit as a flavor or something. I mean, like, just the fruit. You've ever tried it? How did you like it? Did you think it was sweet and tasty, or was it kind of like meh? Because to me, it sure looks pretty, but it's kind of meh. Don't forget to shop the Tutti Frutti collection if you enjoyed this soap. If you'd like to get yourself a bar, well, you know where to get them, royaltysoaps.com at 3 p.m. Central Time. So yeah, you know where to find us, you know where to get them. It's pretty great, right? It's pretty great. I love the stripes, the teeny tiny little stripes in there. It makes me wonder how many layers I could fit into a soap. Think Polish Mountain, but a bar of soap. Like, how tall could I feasibly get one? I feel like it's ridiculous because I could make a mold like 12 feet tall and just pour. We don't want to do that. That'd probably be a world record though. Maybe it should be how many layers can I get into a purple mold? Like one of the ones that we use in the Royal Creative Academy. Maybe I should do that. Like how many layers can I get in there? Maybe it could be like a challenge. Would you guys be interested in a video of me doing that? Let me know. Be sure you do something fun for yourself today. Like going to the store and trying some dragon fruit for the first time. Let me know what you think. Or perhaps getting some candied mango. It's very good if you like tropical fruits and mango. I know there's a lot of people who don't, but if you're into that kind of thing, try a candied mango. It's really good. I don't really care what you do. I just want you to have an absolutely royal day. Be sure you take care of yourself today. Also, I'm just gonna throw this out there. If you are a royal VIP, which just means that you're signed up for my email list, I send an email once a month or so. I'm gonna try to send you guys some more because you've asked for some more, so maybe like two or three times a month. And those people get to find out what the next collection is before everybody else. And they find out today on release day. That's when I send the newsletter, and in the newsletter, I tell everybody. And by the way, the next collection is
ducks.
So there you go. Now you know. Have an absolutely royal day, and I'll see you guys next Wednesday where we will discover what the next collection is. It's gonna be great. You guys are gonna love it. It's also very predictable if you have been watching this channel for a while. There's your hint. Have a magical day. I'll see you then.